Six Flags Great America has one of the most well-rounded coaster lineups in the country. They have 15 different roller coasters covering all ride types and thrill levels. Plus, they also have a strong non-coaster lineup, so in this video, I will count down my top 15 favorite rides and attractions at this Gurnee, Illinois theme park. Starting off this list at number 15 is American Eagle. This historic wooden roller coaster was not only the first major roller coaster built by Intamin, but it opened as the world's fastest roller coaster and the coaster with the longest drop. While those records have since been broken, American Eagle is still an imposing coaster with its massive wooden support structure as it runs along the perimeter of the park. Sure, the ride's queue line is comically long and the ride rarely races anymore, but the coaster isn't too rough outside of the giant helix, and this helix is taken with so little speed that the bumpiness is comical rather than painful. The second half is slowed by trims, but the ride has a few bunny hills in the first half that offer some weak floater airtime throughout the train. Number 14, Demon. This classic aero looper looks great. The ride has a commanding presence with its rockwork and delightful theme song. That theme song might be the best part about the ride. As for the ride itself, I love the ejector pop of airtime on the first drop in the back and the forceful vertical loops. I grade out on each ride. The second half has a few jerky transitions, but thankfully my head cleared the top of the over-the-shoulder restraint to avoid any pain. Number 13, Tsunami Surge. Now I know this technically is in Hurricane Harbor Water Park next to the main gate, but I'm still counting it as part of Great America for the purposes of this list. Tsunami Surge opened in 2021 as the world's tallest water coaster, standing 86 feet or 26 meters tall. This water coaster uses water jets to propel riders uphill, and unfortunately this one has a speed problem. You crawl at several points, particularly on the turns. However, the ride does have a few steep drops, even if you have too much speed into them, and a triple down finale, so there are at least a few tiny pops of airtime scattered about. And remember, a disappointing water coaster is still a top tier water park attraction overall, as I go into in a separate review. Number 12. Whizzer. This classic Schwarzkopf has a wonderful setting in the woods. Barely any of it can be seen from the pathways. This coaster isn't about the thrills, and that's evident when you see how shallow the drops are. They're more like ramps. Instead, this coaster is about the graceful bank turns and the coaster's unique feel thanks to that inline seating. Number 11, Vertical Velocity. This Intamin Impulse coaster has a simple layout, but it does pack in the thrills. The sense of speed up front is great, and it's really unnerving heading up those spikes. It really feels like you'll shoot off the end. Instead, you stop at the last second, and instead get some nice weightlessness on the way down. Unfortunately, the holding brake doesn't work in this one, but the ride is decent otherwise. Number 10, Justice League Battle for Metropolis. This DC Comics themed dark ride is a nice contrast from the park's thrill machines. The ride has a few nice animatronics in both the queue line and the star of the ride, but most of your time is spent taking aim at screens, and that's fine. Most scenes work well, but the subway sequence at the end is too chaotic and dark, which is an issue that plagues all the Justice Leagues. Number 9, Joker. This SNS Freespin is a chaotic experience. The ride is perfectly smooth between the track work and restraint design, which allows you to enjoy and laugh at the flipping. I got around 4 flips on most of my rides, and the best flips occurred on the first drop and the Raven turn. Number 8, Superman Ultimate Flight. This Bolger & Mabillard flying coaster is one I don't ride too often at Great America, because it usually has one of the worst lines in the park. Nonetheless, it's still a fun ride. Most of the coaster is graceful as you glide past trees and over the queue line, but the pretzel loop is undoubtedly one of the most intense elements on any coaster. It feels like your body will explode from the positive G's as you're thrown towards the ground. Number 7, Giant Drop. This 227-foot or 69-meter tall Intamin Drop Tower is the park's best non-coaster in my opinion. The views of the park from atop the tower are wonderful, and I love the western-themed audio that plays at the top. It accentuates the ride's height, and it builds anticipation for the drop. And that drop occurs with a zero warning. You drop like a rock, and you float the whole way down. Number 6, Viper. This Coney Island Cyclone clone gets a lot of love from enthusiasts, but I personally find the coaster a bit overrated. That being said, it is still a fun ride. Viper doesn't have the crazy airtime of the original Cyclone, but it does have a few instances of floater airtime. Where this coaster excels though is in the smoothness and lateral department. Six Flags seems to take great care of this ride, as it was perfectly comfortable even in a wheel seat, and then all the turnarounds slam you to the side of the train due to their lack of banking. Number 5. Batman the Ride. The original B&M invert has been cloned many times, but that doesn't make Batman the Ride any less impressive. This coaster is a fast flurry of forceful inversions. I always gray out on the vertical loops, and the snap through the other three inversions is really nice. Great America's Batman seems to run faster than most, and the original lets you see why the layout is shaped how it is. Number 4. X-Flight. One of the first B&M wing coasters, X-Flight has a relatively compact layout. Most of the inversions offer some great hang time, while many of the turns and valleys pile on the positive G's. The juxtaposition of float and force is really nice. The coaster also mixes in some awesome near misses, most notably the inline twist through the control tower. The one downside with this coaster is that the vest restraints have no give, so it can take a toll on your collarbone. Number 3. Raging Bull. One of the original B&M hypercoasters provides two radically different experiences depending where you sit. In any seat but the back, you are treated to a graceful coaster, mostly free of airtime. It's really boring and uneventful if you're not in the back row. But if you're in the back, you get strong floater airtime on almost every drop. The airtime on the first drop in particular is powerful as it aggressively pops you out of your seat. Raging Bull also features an interesting layout for a coaster of this scale, as it's more of a twister, and it rides very smoothly and always has the best operations of any ride in the park. Number 2. Goliath. This ride is very short, but oh so sweet. Goliath has the least elements of any RMC, but it has several high quality elements. The ejector airtime on the first drop in Camelback is exceptional, and I also love the pull on the dive loop and the sustained hang time on the stall that follows. Now this is probably the worst RMC, but that's only because of the duration. The elements that the ride does feature are really enjoyable. Plus, the ride is still smooth, and it's a wild ride start to finish. And coming in at number 1 is Max Force. The park's newest roller coaster is also my favorite. This S&S compressed air launch coaster holds the record for the fastest acceleration in North America. And that launch is exceptional. There's no countdown, and that launch is very powerful. It feels like you're instantaneously teleported down the track. And the coaster has more to offer than just that launch. The giant inversions at the start and end of the ride offer great hang time, while the barrel roll in between offers some crazy laterals. You are absolutely whipped through that barrel roll. Max Force may be short, but it's an adrenaline rush start to finish, and I kept getting back in line wanting to experience that speed again and again. So those are my top 15 favorite rides and attractions at Six Flags Great America. What are your favorite rides at this park? Or thoughts on any of the attractions that I mentioned? I would love to hear your thoughts down in the comments. If you enjoyed this countdown, I'd appreciate it if you gave this video a like, and you considered subscribing, because there'll be a lot more roller coaster and amusement park videos here at Canopy Coaster. Thanks for watching.